But now, how are they going to react? That's the next question, okay? What are they going to react as? And it turns out that we can basically categorize all reactive organic molecules, it is important, into two different subtypes, okay? And those two subtypes are basically negatively charged species and positively charged species, okay? So a negatively charged species, I know you've heard these words before, but I'm just going to remind you of what they are. A negatively charged species is known as a nucleophile. Okay? And the way that I'm going to, for this course, abbreviate nucleophile is I'm often going to write NU negative. Okay? And that stands for the fact that I have a negatively charged atom. Okay? And instead, or a negatively charged atom or a negatively charged part of a molecule. And the important thing here is that I'm generalizing because it's going to react about the same way no matter what type of nucleophile it is. As long as it's a nucleophile, it's going to react in certain types of reactions. All right? Then the positively charged ones are going to be known as electrophiles. Okay? Electrophiles, I'm going to go ahead and summarize them using E+, meaning that it's a positively charged substance. And I also do want to talk about these names a little bit. What does nucleophile mean in electrophile? Well, if it's negatively charged, that means that what it wants is positive in order to balance out, right? So nucleophile literally means it's a nucleus lover, or it's a proton lover, okay? So a nucleophile is going to want positive charges, like protons, in order to balance. Same thing with an electrophile. An electrophile has a positive charge, so it's going to want electrons to bond with, or to react with, in order to balance out that positive with a negative, all right? So that's the way we think about it, but if you just want, just think the nucleophile is the negative and the electrophile is the positive. All right? So now we look at all of these reagents, okay? I gave you 8. And what I want you guys to do is figure out which of these are going to react more as electrophiles and which of them are going to react more as nucleophiles. For a few of these, that's easy. For a few of these, we can automatically tell, okay? So let me go ahead and tell you guys which ones are the easy ones to identify. Okay, B is easy to identify, E is easy to identify, and actually D is easy to identify. Okay, so for these, already just without knowing the next rule I'm going to teach you, you should be able to tell me if these are going to react as nucleophiles or electrophiles.